freedom. The kingdom is here. I lay down my old flames to carry your new fire today. Where there is new wine, where there is new wine, there is new power, there is new freedom. And the kingdom is here. I lay down my old flames to carry your new fire today. To carry your new fire today. To carry your new fire today.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, prayer warriors. Arise and shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Your sons and daughters will come from afar, and many shall come to the dawning of your new day. It's a new day. God is busy pouring new wine into your life this morning hours. We are having special prayer meetings for Queen Esther Conference that is coming up from the 6th to the 8th of October in Windhoek, Namibia. And I am inviting you, if you didn't get your ticket yet, please make sure you get your ticket, just to avoid, you know, being held up at the door. Don't miss this event. We had a wonderful time last year in Windhoek, Namibia, with different kind of speakers. And this year, we have very anointed speakers. And I want to invite you. We've got Apostle Erna Goedhart, all the way from East London in South Africa. Prophetess Delaine Naidu from Durban, South Africa. And we've got Prophetess Rachel Mayer from South Africa. These are blessed women of God. You are going to miss out if you're going to miss this conference. There is Prophetess Trish. It looks like there's a very strong prophetic unction upon this conference. Prophetess Trish Mukwala from Zambia. Prophetess Lorica Duplessis, all the way from Chumep in Namibia. Dr. Shirley Magazi from Windhoek. Elvara Tron, all the way from Hobabas. And Pastor Magda Diergaard from Windhoek, Namibia. It is a mixture of anointings in one place. And I think we are now 10 days away from the conference. And my heart is beating faster and stronger because I'm getting excited. But this morning, the reason why we are gathering, we're going to pray for this conference. And we're going to talk a little bit about what God is going to do and what God is saying. And we are pressing in. Because this conference is not about gender. Men are also welcome. It's just that we don't advertise it at that level. But men, there's always men. Since the beginning of Queen Esther, this is the 8th one. There's always men in this conference because there was a king in the story. I want you just to get ready as we're going to petition God this morning for a women's movement in the nation of Namibia. That God will begin to move women and change the lives of women and pour out new wine into our presence. Yes, one night with a king can change everything.
Changes everything.
change my course. One moment in His presence, and I've never been the same. One night with the King changes everything. Holy Spirit, we just love on you this morning hours. I'm so madly in love with you. I cannot walk without you. I cannot move without you. I cannot wake up in the morning without you. That's why I'm saying good morning, Holy Spirit. You're the sweetest person that I've ever met. I love you so much. I just want you this morning to just love on the Holy Spirit. Love on Him. He is your helper. He's your best friend. And there's nobody like Him. Jesus Christ, I'm madly in love with you. I thank you for saving my soul. I thank you for this opportunity that I can call upon you this morning. Daddy, what is my life without you? Thank you so much. I just honor you and I worship you because you are all I have, my everything. Can you just worship right where you are? Just worship Him. Just open up your heart and open up your hands and lift up your hands and magnify Him.
Know that all of my dreams could become realities. Then I saw His face. His love captured me.
Welcome this morning to our prayer warriors on the platform. I want to greet Jennifer Duplessy all the way from Wolfish Bay this morning. Apostle Romy van Veek from Rehoboth. Such a joy always when you are tuned in. Vivian Mutseng all the way from Katima Malilu. A very happy birthday to you, Vivian. You are a blessing in my life. And a happy birthday to my son, David, the man of God. Pastor Roberto Beacus, all the way from Oranjemund. We've got the north, we've got the south, we've got the east, we've got the west in this house today. Hey! Namibia shaken. Gail from Windhoek. Pastor Katie Hammerschlag, all the way from Windhoek. Gaynor from Ochivarongo. Evangelist Monica from Windhoek. And even those that I cannot see at this platform, but I know that you are plugged in. Hallelujah. Make sure if you want to be part of Revival Radio, to be in that group, you can send your number to me and I can add you to this group. This is where we communicate while we are praying. I just want to get ready. We are gonna pray in a minute or two.
I keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know.
The orphan girl Hadassah was a savior to a people. And as we all know, that the king was looking for somebody that could replace Queen Vashti, because according to him, Queen Vashti disobeyed him. But that is a debate for even another day, because Queen Vashti knew her value. And she didn't want to come and parade before some drunk men. But the king took it as if Vashti didn't obey him and embarrassed him. And he dethroned her. And then they went out on a search and they looked for young girls. And Hadassah was one of these girls that was found. And they went to the palace and they were prepared for a time such as that. And there was this man that knew all the secrets of the king, that knew exactly the perfumes the king would love, the food. And this man started preparing Hadassah for the throne. She thought she was just one of those girls. But she didn't realize that God had a divine plan with her life. And a long story short, because I don't want to delve into that this morning, because we're going to pray for 7 days for the conference. And this is day one. Hallelujah. I don't want to dwell into that this morning. But eventually, Hadassah was chosen. She was the chosen one. She was an orphan girl, but God saw a queen in the orphan girl. And God has a tendency of specializing in things that people don't think something about. He has a tendency in specializing in people that others have written off. He has a tendency in taking the ones at the back of the line and bringing them all the way to the front. And I just love it, because that's the nature of God, where he goes out and he is a doctor in developing people. And I just love that nature of God. He makes something great of nothing. And that is what he has done with Esther. But I'll be coming back to the book of Esther in these 7 days. This morning, I want to talk about the theme of the 8th Queen Esther conference. And the theme is new wine in new wineskins, taken from the book of Mark chapter 2 verse 22. But I want to take our prayer session from John chapter 2 this morning. The first miracle that Jesus did, changing water into wine. And I want you to open up your heart, because there's some situations about to change in your life. There's a turnaround anointing on this platform this morning, and he's about to change your situation into a supernatural state. People will not understand what happened to you. People will not understand, how did you change overnight? How did your situation of a lack of money change into being a millionaire overnight? How did your marriage that was at the brink of a divorce changed overnight? And that is what God is doing in our lives. New wine in new wineskins.
In the pressing, you are making new wine. Yes, you are. In the soil I now surrender, you are breaking new ground. Oh, you are breaking new ground. Make me an offering. Make me whatever.
Now, I'm reading from the book of John, chapter 2. On the third day, and I always say to people that when you read the word of the Lord, you read as if you are the teacher. You are looking for key words, and you're looking for the revelation in the Word of God. You are looking into the Word with a 3D spectacle on you. On the third day, not the second day, not the first day, the third day. On the third day, there was a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited with his disciples to the wedding. And when the wine was all gone, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no more wine." When the wine was gone, Jesus said to her, "Dear woman, what is that to do to you and to me? What have we in common? Leave it to me. My time," the Amplified is saying, "my hour to act, my time, my moment has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Whatever he says to you to do, do it." I don't want to read further because there's so much in that portion of scripture. And that is what we're going to pray this morning hours, that God will turn our water into wine. And maybe your wine is finished this morning. Maybe you have given the poor wine to God first, and you're going to give him the best wine because he's changing your water into wine. I want to prophesy this morning to somebody that this is your third day. Somebody say third day, third day, third day. Now, whenever you see and you realize it's a third day, it's a day of resurrection. It's a day when Jesus was resurrected. They thought they're going to bury him. They killed him, and they thought they are done and dusted with him. But on the third day, he rose again. I am speaking to your spirit man and say, this is your third day. You are rising up from wherever you are, and you are coming out from obscurity. You are coming out from the hidden place. It is your third day. Now, the mother of Jesus was in that wedding. Let's say if Mary wasn't there, there would not be somebody that knew the potential of Jesus and the power of Jesus. Because the Bible says that this is the first miracle that Jesus did. And after this miracle, verse 11 is very clear on that. Let me read it to you. This portion is really exciting me. Verse 11 says, "This, the first of his signs, miracles, and wonders Jesus performed to in Cana of Galilee and manifested his glory. It was the first. And he displayed his greatness and his power openly, which means there's greatness and there's power inside of you that has not been displayed openly. But there's coming a day and an hour, and that day is today, that God is going to display his power and the glory that is inside of you openly, publicly. There's coming a time where God is revealing who you are publicly. Maybe your husband know who you are, your children know who you are, your ministry know who you are, but your town doesn't know who you are, and your nation doesn't know who you are. I am telling you right now that there's coming an hour where God is displaying the glory he has invested in you at a public place, at a public place, and he's going to promote you nationwide. He's going to promote you at a level where everybody will know who you are and what is inside of you. There's coming a public display of the glory of God in your life. Get ready for that. Hallelujah. Now, verse 11 continue to say that his disciples believed in him and relied on him after this miracle. If Mary wasn't in the room, they would not know, the disciples would not know who is in the room. There needs to be somebody in the room that knows who you are, that will place a demand on the anointing that is upon you, that will unlock your fullness and your supernatural power, and that places a demand upon you. Let me tell you this morning, hours, we are going to pray that God will bring the third day anointing into the Queen Esther conference. But not only that the people that's coming, the woman and the man that's coming, will know how to place a demand on the Holy Spirit. They will know how to place a demand on the speakers. They will know how to place a demand on God, so that the supernatural power of God will be revealed at this conference. I want us to pray this morning, hours, that God will do wonders, signs, and miracles. I want to just quickly also show you another secret in this portion of scripture. Now, Jesus said to Mary, my time has not yet come. Let me tell you, when there's somebody placing a demand upon your life, or you place a demand on somebody's life, there is a principle of demand and supply. Whenever there's a demand, there is a supply, and that is a business principle. When there's a need, there becomes a supply, a demand and a supply. For instance, in the time of COVID, whoever thought something of masks and sanitizers? We just thought it's a Chinese wearing mask. But when there was a need, it became a demand. And there was a supply for that. Now, it was not the time of Jesus, but because Mary knew who Jesus was, she placed a demand. And what did she do? The demand brought acceleration to Jesus. Jesus said, it's not my time. But because of the needs, we went into the future. We went into time, into eternity. And we brought time to the present. And we pressed the button of acceleration. And Jesus probably was not in the mood. Jesus was probably not ready for that miracle, that his first miracle. But Mary knew who Jesus was, and she placed a demand because there was a need, and she accelerated the power of God, the glory of God, and she brought what was in the future into the presence.
I'm here this morning to tell you that whatever is meant for your future, there's a release right now. It's coming into your present. Let us pray this morning, ours. Father God, this morning I pray for the conference. I pray for this conference that is laying ahead of us. Father God, I pray for a demand. I pray for a supply. Father, there's a need of woman, Father God, that needs to be touched. Father, there is woman coming from all places. There's woman coming from different towns, my God. And Father, you knew exactly what their needs are. Father, you know whether the wine has dried up in their lives. You know if they've whether they really experience, Father God, a situation or experience of having wine in their lives, my God. But this morning, Father, I pray that you will change their lives already now. Your word says to me, call upon me and I will answer you. Your word says to me, before I call, you will answer me. Father, I stand on that word this morning and I pray for every woman coming to the conference of Queen Esther that you already hear their prayer right now, Father. By the time they come to the conference, they're coming to a place of celebration. They're coming to a place, a wedding celebration, my God. They're coming just to enjoy what God has done. I pray for those women, Father, and I pray for every man coming to that conference that you already change their situation around. Whatever is looking so impossible to them, you will change it around, Father. In the name of Jesus, you will change it, Father. Whether it's a marriage, Father God, that you need to change. Father, whether it's a child that is a problem in a home, you will change it around, Father. The tears of a woman are being caught up this morning in the heavenlies. And that tears are being changed, oh God, into glory. Every story has been changed into glory, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. I pray this morning that you will draw women from all sides of Namibia, just as we are presented on this platform, from the far north, as far as Katima, Father God, I and as far as Oranje Mond this morning, and Wolfish Bay and Hubabas, oh God, Father, and Windhoek and all the central parts of Namibia, Father, I pray that your spirit will be poured out upon Namibia, and Father, you will draw women into this place, women and men into this place, because Queen Esther is not a gender thing, oh God. Your word says there is no gender in the spirit, oh Father God, but it is a spiritual move of God. Father, draw them to this conference, draw them with a desire to this conference, draw them to the place of visitation, my God. Draw them to the place of acceleration. I pray acceleration in the Queen Esther conference. I pray a Queen Esther anointing into this place. I pray a kingly anointing into this place, a priestly anointing into this place, that they will begin to know who their God is, because the book of Daniel says, and they shall call upon their God. They that know their God will do great exploits. I pray that every woman will understand her role in that place. place, oh God. Father God, when they step into this place, they're stepping into it, Father God, as queens and not as princesses, as kings, oh God, and not as princes. I pray that people will understand their position this morning, the position in the spirit, that we are seated in heavenly places, that our feet, oh God, is the place, the resting place. Father, that the enemy is under our feet, Father. I pray for a place of elevation this morning. I pray for a place of promotion this morning. That, Father God, by the name of Jesus, that you will raise up, Father God, queens this morning and kings in the spirit. That they will begin to get dressed, oh God. That the right linen will be put upon them. That the crown will be put upon their lives, oh God. That you will crown people in this hour, Father God, for the position of the throne. Oh Father, I prophesy this morning that the throne are being prepared for you. The throne of God are being prepared for you. That God will arise from his throne because he's dancing over you with joy and he wants to seat you at a high place. You are not nothing, but you are somebody this morning, ours. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for who you are. I thank you. I thank you for the lamp of God. The lamp of God in the midst of Queen Esther. I thank you. I thank you. I worship you this morning. I thank you for the lamp of God. I thank you for the throne of God this morning. Father, we petition your throne. We petition your throne, oh God. And Father, we pray for favor for this conference. Already I see the favor. Already I'm experiencing the favor of this conference. Thank you for your provisions. Thank you for the people that has already booked their tickets. Thank you for those already making contact. Thank you for those that ears are inclined to the sound. The sound of the new wine. Father, thank you for those that you have already positioned for this conference. Thank you for the speakers of this conference. Thank you for the worship teams of this conference. Thank you for the intercessors of this conference. The ushers, oh God. The doorkeepers, Father God. The gatekeepers, the watchers, my God. Thank you, Father God, for those that is coming in your throne room, Father. We petition your throne this morning, ours. And I pray, oh God, that you will do wonders, signs, and miracles. Just like the day at the wedding of Cana, where you change water into wine, my God, that there will be a turning around anointing. Change situations right now in people's life. Oh, Father God, the lamp of 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 God. We petition the throne 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 of God. We petition the lamp of God. We petition the lamp of God this morning. Jesus Christ, let there be a move of the Holy Spirit. Let there be a move of the supernatural. Let there be a move of acceleration power, of demand and supply, my God. Oh, Karabaya Kerebasata. Let there be a public display of the glory of God. Let there be a display that people will believe in Jesus Christ. Let there be a harvest of souls. I pray specifically for women that doesn't walk with the Lord closely, that they will attend this conference and their lives will be changed. I cry for a harvest of souls. I pray for the spirit of revival in this conference. In the name of Jesus, Makaya Rabaya Kere. Erebosia. Eshetele baba 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 sata. Oshatala basianda la basete. Rebakaya masianda la bose. Osikala basianda la basia. Oshatala basata la basete. Makaya rabaya kereboso. Oh, the lamp of God, the lamp of God, the lamp of God. May the lamp of God be experienced of in this conference. May the lion of the tribe of Judah arise in this conference. Behold the lamb, behold the lamb. I want you to pray in tongues for a minute. Just pray in tongues for Queen Esther Conference 2023. Pray in tongues. Makaya masata labasata labasata. We are approaching the throne of God boldly by the grace of God. We behold the lamp of God. The heavens are open over this conference. Makaya rabayekere baba baba shende. Approach the throne of God. Approach the lamp of God. Approach the lion of Judah. Makaya ribaka setele bakaya masata la basanda. Rekoto loko sekere baba handa la bayeke. Oshotorobo sende. The lamp of God, the lamp of God, the lamp of God. Mashatarabondi.
Thank you, Jesus, for loving me so.
Never, never, never know.
For loving me so. Yeah.
Thank you for your blood. Yeah.
There's something about the name Jesus. I speak Jesus into Queen Esther Conference. I speak Jesus to every woman coming to that conference. You know exactly who's going to be there. You know their names. You understand them from afar. You know even from which towns they are coming from. You know who will enter into that place, oh God. There's something about the name Jesus. I speak Jesus over these people. I speak Jesus over these people. Now in the name of Jesus. Makarabayendere. Soto Rekabasianda Labas Satarabas Satarabas Sete Reco Tarabas Senderebo Sete.
But I want you to know that there will come a time when every Muslim, when every Buddhist, when every Jew will have to get down on their knees. And have to confess that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. So I want every blood-washed believer to not wait until then. And if you've ever gone through something, you know right here,
tell us
that there's something about the name.
Something, y'all.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name.
Something about the name Jesus.
It's the sweetest name.
I want you to pray with me. Begin to say Jesus. Begin to say Jesus. Begin to speak Jesus over every woman. begin to speak Jesus over every man. Just speak to Jesus to Queen Esther right now in the name of Jesus. Speak Jesus to your town. Speak Jesus to your city. Speak Jesus to your nation. Speak Jesus to this conference. Speak Jesus to this continent. Speak Jesus into your home right now. There's something about the name Jesus. Just call upon the name of Jesus and you will be saved. Just say Jesus this morning. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Call upon the name of Jesus. Cry out and say Jesus.
That fire
said it's just like fire.
Where's it? Where's
it? Shut up in my mood.
Holy Ghost.
When the Holy Ghost gets a movement, said he won't leave me alone.
Bring up with us, y'all. Bring up with us, man. Everybody.
Something, something.
Yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name.
Something about the name Jesus.
It's the sweetest name, yeah.
It is the sweetest name.
Sweetest name I know.
I know.
Wave at me if you love that name.
Jesus in our homes, Jesus in our streets, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I prophesy that this conference, Father God, is aligning to what you want to do in this nation. Father God, that you will birth, Father God, mothers that will give birth to sons of God. Father, spiritual mothers, spiritual fathers, that it will birth spiritual fathers. It will birth, Father God, leaders at the next level. Father God, even as we are at this venue of Augustinium Secondary School, Father God, we could have tried a better venue. We could have tried a more expensive or more glamorous venue. But Father, this is the venue you have appointed for a time such as this, because this venue carry governmental anointing, Father God, as many of our government leaders were produced through this school. Father, we have built an altar. I pray that the altar at Augustinium Secondary School will speak for this conference at a national level in the name of Jesus Christ. I say, let the voice of the altar speak. Let the voice of the land of Augustinium speak. The ground of Augustinium will speak on behalf of this conference, that you will raise up governmental leaders in this conference in the mighty name of Jesus. You will raise up an army that will take over government in this conference in the name of Jesus. You will raise up voices for this nation in this conference in the name of Jesus. Makaya masata laba sata rekotorabo soto rabababababababa sanda rekotorabo soto rebaka sata raba sata rebabababababa sanda rabo sete rebakaya masata rebakaya rabahanda raba sata. I speak Jesus. I speak Jesus. I speak Jesus over Queen Esther this morning. Jesus, you are in the room, and there's somebody called Mary that knows who you are. There's people that know who you are, and we place a demand on you, Jesus, this morning. In Jesus' mighty name, we speak Jesus.
I speak the name of Jesus over every heart and every mind, 'cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is love.
Somebody say Jesus. Can somebody say, Jesus, 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 Savior, we call upon you, Messiah, Redeemer. Jesus, mighty to save. You are mighty to save in this conference. You are mighty to save. You will provide, oh God, every need. You will provide, Father, the needs of the people coming. You will provide, Father God, for every prayer request. You will provide to every woman. Those, Father God, that doesn't even have that $150 Namibian dollars, you will provide supernaturally. Oh, Father God, you will make a way in the desert. You will provide transport. You will provide, Father, a miracle. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's power in the name of 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 Jesus. I speak Jesus into your house right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Makaya rabaya kerebasaya. Whatever you are struggling with, whatever your stronghold is this morning, I speak Jesus over that stronghold. Strongholds break right now. You are being set free right now. I come against every demon forces in your life right now. And I say, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Makaya rabasata. Rekotoroboyende. I want you to pray with me. I don't want you to listen to me. I want you to pray with me. Pray, 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 pray. I push you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Call upon Jesus right now. If you said, just stand up. Just stand up. If you're still in bed, get out of bed and begin to declare Jesus over your situation right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus. Just get up, arise, arise, arise. Just get up, stand up, stand up. If you're still laying down, just stand up from your bed right now. There's a move taking place in your life right now. There's a movement in the spirit taking place. Makayama salaba satala basata. If you have anointing oil right now close to you, begin to anoint yourself for the move of God, the move of God, the move of God. Anoint yourself. It's a fresh anointing. It is water turning into wine. Hallelujah. It is the power of God, a public display of the power of God in your life. Makaya rabasata. Rabakasata rabasata. Rabakayende rebosoto. Rabababababababasata. Rabakasata rabasata. Rabakayende rebosoto rebosoto. Rabakasende rebosianda labasianda. Rebayanda labasata labasata. I want you to push in prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just push in prayer. Makaya rabayende rebasata labasata. There's a breakthrough anointing in your home right now. A turnaround anointing. A public display anointing. And it's the glory of God that will be displayed publicly. God is vindicating you. God is vindicating you publicly. Can somebody say publicly? Just like he displayed the glory of Jesus publicly at a wedding, he's going to display your glory publicly. Hallelujah. Makaya masata rabasata. Just speak Jesus, 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 Jesus. Anamayende lebasi analabasata. Oshetere baba 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 handa. Oshetere basi anda. Satalabasata labasata. Rabakayende rabasu anda labasi anda. Otarabasetere basi anda labasata. Say Jesus, say Jesus, say Jesus, say Jesus. Makaya rabayende rebosia. Osotolobo sotolobo soto. Makarabayende rebosatalabasanda. Isatalabosia karabasatarabasata. Karabasianda labasata. Oshetere baba 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 handa. Oshatarabasende. I want you to pray. I want you to pray. Hallelujah. New wine, new wine, new wine. Makaya masata labasata. Rebakaya masata rabasata. Oshata labasianda labasata labasata. Labasata rabasata. Hekere baba 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 handa. Pour out your new wine in this conference, my God. Oh, that is my prayer this morning hours. New wine, new wine, new wine. Turn water into wine. Turn my water into wine. Hallelujah. Can you cry out to God this morning for him to turn the water in your life into wine? The thing that is bitter into sweet. Hallelujah. Makaya rabayende rebasi andalabasata. Reboko shotorobo soto. Rabakaya masata labayende leba. Just 10 more minutes. Hallelujah. Prayer warriors, let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's push. Hallelujah. Father, we bring this conference before you. We bring this conference before you. In the name of Jesus, may there be an outpouring. May there be an outpouring of your new wine. Hallelujah. Ere ba 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 yende le ba si anda la ba sata. Ere ba 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 sata la ba sata. Ora ba kere ba 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 si anda la ba si tala ba soto. Ere ba 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 sata. O sata la ba yende le ba 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 si anda. O shakara ba sata ra ba sete. Rikoto ra ba soto ra ba soto. Rabaka sata la ba yende le ba si anda la ba sata. New wine, my prayer is for new wine this morning, that you will come, Father God, that the essence of wine will be in the place, the ingredients of the heavenly wine will be in that place. Oh Father, that people's lives are already changing right now. They're changing right now in the name of Jesus. New wine, new wine, new wine, new wine in Jesus' name.
You are breaking new ground. So make me your vessel. Make me an offering. Make me whatever you want me to be.
I want to prophesy this morning, there's a release coming into your life right now. There's a release taking place. You have risen. You have risen from the position where you were. Hallelujah. Kamayende leba sianda. You are breaking new ground. I prophesy new ground to Queen Esther 2023. New wine and new ground. And I prophesy that to your life right now. I prophesy to your life right now. You are breaking new ground. There's something new happening right now. The Bible says, look, it is already happening. Oh, kamayende leba sata. It is the 8th Queen Esther and 8th speaking of new beginnings. It's new beginnings, new wine. It is something new. New ground, hallelujah. New people, hallelujah. Makaya masata. I call in a harvest of new people. Not just the old people that attended Queen Esther, but the new people. Hallelujah. I speak to the atmosphere in Namibia. I say you will obey the word of the Lord. If South Africa can hear the sound, hallelujah, of this new wine, and there's people coming to attend, only to attend, coming to this conference, oh God. Father God, Namibians can also be sensitive. I pray for new ground, new ground, new ground, that Queen Esther will break new ground. I prophesy that this conference will break new ground in this year, in the name of Jesus. New wine, hallelujah, new ground, hallelujah, a new thing, Father, acceleration, new acceleration, a public display of the glory of God at Queen Esther Conference in the name of Jesus, Father. Hallelujah. I bless your name, Father God. I thank you this morning for new wine. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit. Carry your new fire today. Where there is new wine, where there is new wine, there is new power, there is new freedom, and the kingdom's here. I lay down my old flames to carry your new fire today, to carry your new fire today, to carry your new fire today.
I want to just read you these words that I was blessed by Apostle Sydney with the other night. I was asking God something particular, and when I woke up, He sends me these words that made so much sense for that situation in that time. You need to understand that God is raising Esther's. I just want to share this with you because it's so relevant to the conference, and I want to declare it over this conference. Esther's don't fall for the compromise or the counterfeit. I had a dream last week where I was watching a bizarre thing take place. I saw a woman who was carrying a rod of authority in one hand and a trumpet in the other. She was called to overturn injustice, speak forth God's heart. And I could see the potency of a calling and a courage. But in a moment of weakness, she laid down her tools and wrapped herself in a jacket that was not meant for her. And it caused her to go into hiding. And as she lifted her voice, instead of a booming roar, came the soft squeak of a mouse. I feel we are at a moment where the enemy is afraid of the Esthers who would step up and into the authority and is right now trying to bully them into hiding or have them wear the counterfeit mantles they were not called to wear. In the last week, the war of intimidation and mind games have increased and tried to get you to run into hiding or into false covering of a safe assignment. There is no safe, only the place of complete protection by being in your genuine assignment. There's no plan B. You have run long enough. You have stayed silent enough. No more. The enemy is also trying to stir up insecurity, comparison, and an orphan mindset to take you off course. And your signs of the enemy and your sights of the enemy, don't fall for the games. Lord, expose the areas of counterfeit and compromise that would hold back an army of Esther's called to crush the enemy, reign over cities, regions, and take back the land in Jesus' name. Esther, arise. I want to say this morning, Esther, arise. Esther, arise. It is the 8th Queen Esther conference taking place. And I want to thank you this morning that you have prayed with me. We're going to pray for 7 days, and this was day one. Hallelujah. So I'll be meeting you tomorrow at this place again. Hallelujah. At this place again, 6 o'clock, 6 to 7. We're going to push in prayer over this week for this conference, because there's an acceleration in the house. There's water being turned into wine. There's new wine into new wineskins. There's a public display of the glory of God in your life going to take place. There's souls that's going to be saved. I want to ask every woman listening to my voice, make sure you get to this conference. It's in Windhoek Augustinium Secondary Hall, School Hall. And I want to ask women on this platform, and especially the group of Queen Esther, if you can invite women and urge the people to book their tickets, because these days the tickets are flying now. Book your tickets and make sure that you are present at this conference. I mentioned the different speakers in the beginning of this program. People are coming from South Africa. There's Dr. Valencia coming. She's just coming to attend with a group of women, you know. And we have people from Zambia coming. And we are Namibians in the house. I love Namibia so much. And I want to invite you, and I want to thank you for praying with us this morning hours. I just want to bless you with a song to say, you will not be quiet. You will not be quiet, because the Lord is going to raise you up. You will not be silent. Hallelujah. Makataraba senderebo sanda. I want to bless you this morning hours. The name of Jesus is greater than any other name. Hallelujah. May you be blessed. May the Lord be before you. May the Lord's hand be upon your life. And may you go out today and be new wine. I see you tomorrow morning once again as we're going to push in prayer.
You are worthy. And no one can worship you for me. You've done for me, and no one can worship you for me.
Lift it up.
Here's my worship, all of my worship. Receive my worship, all of my worship. Here's my worship,
all of mine,
all of my worship.
Father, receive my
worship.